Michael, JT, and myself decided to make an electromagnet for our last physics project. If you don't remember from class, an electromagnet is a temporary magnet that is created by inducing an electrical current around a metal rod. Inside the rod, there are billions of electrons whizzing all over the place. But when a wire is coiled around the rod and an electrical current is sent through it, it aligns the electrons, which creates an electric field. This field can become weaker or stronger depending on the amount of coils and electricity which pass through it. We are about to show you how this works. Creating an electromagnet is relatively simple because you only need a few materials. These materials include a metal core, some insulated copper wire, and some batteries. You also want a pair of wire cutters so that way you can strip about an inch of the insulation off of the copper wires so that way you can connect it to your battery and power source. Now that we have gathered all of our materials, we will begin to wrap the wire around the core so that we can make our electromagnet.
Have the wire coiling in the opposite direction.
Yeah, no, we don't want that.
So what we should just tape it at the end.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I can hold it.
Now that we have our electromagnet, it's time to test it out to see if it will actually work.
So we built an electromagnet, and here we have a 12-volt battery and a piece of steel rod and a 16-gauge copper wire. And electromagnets depend on two things mainly for their strength. The strength of the electric current passing through the wire, and also the amount of coils that are wrapped around the rod. So we wrapped this coil as tightly as we could go around the rod, and then we attached it to the 12-volt battery, and as you can see, it's a pretty strong magnet right here because there are three paper clips sticking up. And JT can attach his nail to the end of battery.
Now, the farther away from the source of power, the weaker the magnet is going to be. So right now, it's pretty easy to get the nail off of the magnet itself. And as I go closer to the power source, it gets progressively harder to take it off. Now down here, it's pretty difficult to take the nail off the magnet.
And you can even take this hole puncher and attach it to the magnet here, and it stays. So when you take away the power source, then the magnet will lose its magnetic charge. If I can,
yeah, let me do it.
Okay.
Now we're going to use a 9-volt battery to show that our magnet will now be less strong as there is less current flowing through it. Before, when we put the paper clips on, there were many that were able to stay on and stay upright. At first you will see that this will stay upright, but when we try to put another paper clip on, it automatically falls and falls off because our magnet isn't as strong. Now if we were to do this at the other end, you definitely will see that they won't stay on because this doesn't even stay on by itself. Before we had the magnet easily staying on, and now it falls off first time.
Now we are going to use a AA battery, which is 1.5 volts, to show that we will have a very weak magnet.
As you can see, the paperclip cannot even remain upright because the magnet is very weak, even at its strongest point. And then when you take it to the end, it doesn't even stick.
Okay, so this time we took off about half the coils that we had coiled on the rod, and now we have it attached back to the 12-volt battery, and we're going to try to see how less coils affect the strength. So I have this paper clip, and we're going to attach the paper clip to the metal rod here, and it just completely falls off. There's no magnetism attracting it. when you go up to the strongest part of the battery, it does stay upright, but you can see that it's significantly weaker than it was before. You can also take this nail, which was staying on before, and it still stays on at the top, but you can see it's much less attracted to the magnet. And down here, it's not being attracted at all, it's just